Welcome to Good Libations. I'm Ethel Andrews. I'm a mixologist, and we're striving to make drinks that are suitable for any functions that we might have during the colder months of Southern California, which sounds like a total oxymoron, but we do have cold months. Autumn and winter, we want drinks that have a little more substance to them, that are a bit more suitable to entertaining in the cold weather for any family gatherings or parties that we may have. And we want to try to go beyond the eggnog and rum or brandy stereotype and beyond the drinks that are made with coffee and alcohol, because those drinks are good and they're worthy. But most of us have made plenty of those over the years, and we want to kind of expand our horizons a bit. And we want to go beyond too classics such as Brandy Alexanders, Ramos Fizzes, Black Russians, White Russians, Grasshoppers, any of those sort of drinks, which are good in cold weather because, again, they're heavier, but they've been made frequently over the years and have almost become a stereotype. And what we're going to do today, like we did on one of our previous episodes, is we're going to make a drink that is brandy-based and done in a shaker with the addition of another liqueur to add difference to it and substance to it. And we're going to put our float of heavy cream, hopefully, on the top. And as we saw in the previous episode, sometimes we're going to have spills. And sometimes when we endeavor to do things like get cream to float on the top of a drink, or anything to float, and we talked about black and tans, where sometimes the Guinness will not float on the amber ale, things are going to happen. But you just carry on and continue on in your endeavors and don't feel defeated. And remember, mixology is an art in that we want to make things that are innovative and interesting. But everything sometimes is not always going to be perfect. It may fall slightly short in the presentation, and we might make mistakes, but carry on with your endeavors and continue to try to be creative and interesting in your making of cocktails. So we're going to go ahead and make another brandy-based winter-autumn cocktail. And this one, too, is done in a shaker and can be served either, again, in a footed glass, footed pedestal glass, or a wine stemware type glass. So I'm going to go ahead and put the ice in the shaker again. And as I mentioned, we're not shaking martinis, so we don't have to put a huge amount of ice in the glass, just enough to get it cold, but not ridiculously so. So I'm going to go ahead and put the brandy in. And if you have deep pockets, you could get a really fancy upscale brand of brandy, but most of us are of a more modest budget, so we have to settle for things that are not rot gut, but are not really expensive. Now, when it comes to things that we add, however, quality can be very important. We used the cinnamon-based Gold Rush liqueur before. This time we're going to make what you might call a Danish Alexander, because it's brandy based, but we're going to use cherry herring, which is a really nice specialty liqueur that is made in Denmark by Peter Herring and has been made for a very long time via his own formula. So we're going to add the cherry herring to our drink, maybe a little bit more, and we're going to shake it up really nicely, and then we're going to dispense it into our glass. And again, I think we're going to use the nice footed glassware because I really like that. And yes, again, it is a glass that is designed to drink scotch out of, single malt scotch out of, but we're using it for a different purpose today. So we're going to go ahead and shake it up. And disperse it into the glass. And then we're going to try to get a nice float of heavy cream over the top that hopefully this time will not blend into the drink. So we'll see what happens. And I'm gonna go ahead and shake the heavy cream again. And as I mentioned before, if you have trouble getting this to float perfectly, you might want to whip it up a little bit. And this is whipping cream, actually. And if you do that, if nothing else, you could leave a dollop on the top if you can't get the float. But we'll see if we can achieve a float on this one this time. Hopefully we can. And it helps if the glass is cold, it helps if the spoon is cold, and it helps if the cream is somewhat whipped up. And again, you hold a spoon upside down at an angle and endeavor to pour the cream over the top. And this time we did get a float without it going down the sides, which is truly nice. Although I got some over the edge, but at least it didn't blend into the drink, which is what we want to aim for. Because the eye appeal is there, and again, you're drinking that lovely drink through the cream instead of the cream mixing in with it. And that way you get a better tasting drink, I think. The alcohol flavors really stand out. Not the harshness of the alcohol, but the flavor of the base liquors that you're using. In this case, the brandy and the cherry herring. And I'm going to go ahead and give it a taste and see how it turned out. That is very nice. And I would say that the portion of cherry herring to the brandy is about right. Neither one is overwhelming the other. The brandy stands out as it should, but you can taste the cherry herring as well. Very, very good. And again, for those who like a sweeter drink, they could add more cherry herring. They could use liqueurs that contain other fruit infusions, if they like that. If they want to, they can combine triple sec with the brandy or Cointreau, whatever it may be. So again, this is a very worthy, very nice drink for pairing with winter appetizers, winter desserts, and fall style desserts and appetizers. Very, very nice, and that cream is maintaining its integrity and that it's keeping afloat over the top. So the key again always seems to be if you can shake it up really good without having to resort to whip it, and if the spoon is sufficiently cold and the glassware is sufficiently cold, usually you'll get a float. And of course, the specific gravity is the important thing too, that allows things to leave afloat over the top. That's why Guinness will float on the top of the amber ale or the red ale. It's a specific gravity issue. So again, enjoy your libations and be creative, be innovative, try new things. Try to get out of the stereotype of the Irish coffees, the Keoki coffees, the Brandy Alexanders, the Black Russians and so forth, and try something different. And Ramos Fizzes are mostly a brunch drink anyway, but they can be served this time of the year also in our evening and afternoon parties and functions. And again, let's be sensible and cautious when it comes to our drinking and show consideration for our community, for other people in our community, and for ourselves. And we want to thank you for tuning in to another episode of Good Libations. I'm Ethel Andrews, I'm a mixologist, and hopefully we will see you soon, and we will definitely have future episodes. Thank you again. Goodbye.